Aloha and welcome. It is April 8th, 2023 with us in this room. You may be seeing this, I don't know, whenever. Emi and I are going to do another sound journey. Surprise. You joined a thing called Saturday Sound Journey. Guess what's going to happen? I was right. I put out on the little thing for Facebook that we were playing to a packed house, not knowing that we would be playing to a packed house. It's awesome. Yay. Very grateful for that. Thanks for all for being here. As I was telling these wonderful folks, a couple of whom are here for their first time, listening to this, especially at nice volume, moves a lot of energy in your body. And sometimes that energy move finds the blocks that you may have built in. If you're like me, there's more than one through childhood trauma, emotional trauma, sometimes my wrist from an old accident, things like that. So sometimes when the energy is moving and it finds blockages, it can cause a little bit of discomfort, a little bit of muscle cramping or quivering or, you know, any number of things. The key to moving past that is finding your breath. So I encourage you to do that. I find my breath and I call on my Middle Earth dwarves to take their pickaxes to any blockages and remove them, which I find particularly useful. It's always a decent idea to ask those blockages what they're there for, because maybe you're not done with them, or maybe you want to be done with them, and finding out what they are about will allow you to release and let the energy flow more better. Yay. We're gonna do loud and soft and loud and soft. The sound volume will vary considerably, and then it's gonna get very quiet for a few moments while I move over to that rap drum. And then I'll play that for a few minutes, and then we'll let it sit silent for a short period of time. The invitation during that time is to just breathe and be with your body. Welcome yourself back in. I will talk you back in. And just be aware of where you are. When I'm on your end of the journey, I like to do a body scan before I start and find out what's going on. Become aware of tensions or things that are moving through my brain too fast or whatever. And then do another scan at the end and find out what's different, just to be aware. Always a good practice to be aware of what's going on for your body and your mind and your spirit. So without further ado, my queen and I shall be breathing three times together. When we do that, we grow roots to ground in. I make up that the deeper I'm grounded, the higher I can fly. Yes. Setting up those roots allows for you to let go of any energy that's ready to let go. Give it to Mama Gaia. She'll take it. She'll transmute it. She'll use it elsewhere. And she will bring gifts back up to you. This is a morphogenic field of evolution. Welcome, welcome. Even you, whenever you're here, if you're not live with us, are part of the morphogenic field. So thank you for bringing your energy, and I hope you get everything you can out of it.
You may want to set an intention.
Oh, intentions. I intend for my cat to be comfortable, despite the explosive nature of our neighborhood. Maybe she'll come back and join us. Okay, off we go. Have a pleasant journey. We'll see you in about an hour.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
as this sound journey draws to a close, the last of these vibrations move off to do magic in the universe. The invitation is to find your breath. To just become aware of how it's flowing in and out of your body. And then to allow that awareness to gently guide your consciousness back into this meat sack you call a home. And as your awareness slides back in, you may find that there are parts that are tired of being still. I encourage you to allow movement. No need to rush. You can just allow that movement to arise spontaneously. It's always amazing to me that when I really stop and pay attention to my breath and my body, just how freaking amazing we really are. Spirits inhabiting flesh, bones, with a gazillion processes happening every second that we don't even have to think about. We just happen. Truly blessed. I saw a podcast with Dr. Zach Bush this week. An interview with Deja Blue. And in it, he was so excited about describing the miraculous functionings of our cells. And in it, he described how our angelic cells spend eons trying to get into this physical form just so we can enjoy coffee. and all the other things that our five senses are required to appreciate, that our disembodied spirits don't have the opportunity to experience. Highly recommended podcast. Totally got me jazzed to be in this body, in this moment. For those of you in the digital world, we bid you a fond adieu. Drink plenty of water over the next 3 days. It'll keep you functioning well and allow anything that's been disrupted due to the sound journey to release and flow out. I know you just look like you got something exciting you want to share. No? Okay. For those of you who celebrate Christ, happy Easter. We're going to have an Easter egg hunt with the little kids. And that's going to be my celebration of joy with God tomorrow. Because kids are awesome. And we have a bunch around the house these days that just thrill my heart. So, blessings. Yummalicious. If you're on YouTube, smash that like button. I'm sure it makes the gods somewhere very happy. And I think it has something to do with the channel growth. I don't know. Yeah. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for spending your time, attention, intention, and blessings on your journey. We'll see you again. Or you'll see us again. We probably won't actually see you because it doesn't work that way.
Not yet. Mahalo and aloha.
Bye-bye.